Hey everybody, it's Invicta, and let's do another arena run! Of course, thank you everybody who's been watching and liking all the Hearthstone content on my channel, as well as a big special thumbs up and high five to all of you new subscribers here. I do appreciate the support. As always, before every arena run, you can find an annotation somewhere in the upper left-hand corner that says, click here to skip the draft, and that will take you straight to game one. And if, just in case if you don't feel like watching the draft process, I personally enjoy watching the draft process, looking at the thought process and the logic behind some choices that people make. It's very interesting to me, but if you're not into that, click the annotation now and throughout the draft process. You can go straight to game one and skip the whole thing. Here we go. I have not started a new arena run since that last Hunter run that did not go so well for us, but hey, it is okay. And I don't know why is it asking me. No, let's not do that. I don't know why I was asking me for my PayPal there, because I did not want to pay it with PayPal. So here we go. We're gonna have Druid, Warrior, and Priest. Now Druid is a class that I've not played in a while in Arena. Warrior is a class that I have played before, but I don't think I've done a Warrior deck on the arena, at least not on the channel. And then Priest, of course, is a deck that got scrapped, except for the huge five-turn slam dunk. I think we're gonna try Druid here. I haven't done Druid yet, and if I have done a Druid run on the channel before, I don't remember it. So we're gonna go with Druid here. We'll pick good old Malfurion. And away we go. First card is going to be Bite, Nourish, or Starfall. Bite is very, very good for removal. Nourish, of course, is super awesome. It gives you mana or gives you three cards. Starfall is great for AoE clearing as well. I think we're going to go Nourish here just to get that super-duper fast acceleration if we need it. Or if we are in a bind, we can use it to draw three cards. Very, very good utility here. Since we have no cards that we picked right now, the safest bet is going to be Nourish, in my opinion, instead of Starfall. Bite is pretty good, but like I said, I'm not looking to build an offensive Druid deck, and by offensive Druid deck I mean using the actual hero, using Malfurion. I'm going to look for minions, so we'll go Nourish here. Silverhand Knight, Elven Archer, and Harvest Golem. Harvest Golem has seen a very, very, I won't say meteoric rise in popularity in Arena, just because of that amazing death rattle. I think we're going to probably go Silverhand Knight here, because as always is what I state with Druids, Shamans, and Paladins, is that they rely on unit retention and being able to buff everything they have on the board. They usually don't play that strong of creatures, but whenever you get a chance to have a card that will draw a second minion for you, guaranteed, is very good. And plus it's a 5 cost for a 4-4 and a 2-2. Very, very good. Priest of Elune, Mark of Nature, and Mark of the Wild here. Mark of Nature is super duper awesome. Gives it a minion plus 4 attack or plus 4 health and taunt. Mark of the Wild is kind of like a cheaper poor man's version of Mark of Nature, except it does add to the attack as well. So instead of just the health, I think we're probably going to go Mark of Nature here. Mark of the Wild is super good, but if I need that taunt, I'm going to give it plus. I'd rather have it plus 4 taunt, plus 4 health plus taunt instead of 2-2. Mark of the Wild. Hopefully we'll see another one. A few of those. This would be very, very nice indeed. Wrath, Youthful Brewmaster, Earthen Ring Farseer. I think we're going to go Wrath here. Wrath is a very good card for removal, and it also has card draw utility in case you need it. It's good for early removal, especially with that 3 focus damage. Stranglethorn Tiger, Chillwind Yeti, and Cultmaster. I love the Tiger here. Unfortunately, we already have 2 5-cost cards, and I can't really in good conscience take another one. I think we're going to go Yeti here. Yeti is one of the best 4-cost minions in the game. You get a 4-5 for 4-cost. Cultmaster is super good, but right now our card draw is looking somewhat healthy between Wrath and Nourish, so I'm not too worried about it right now, so we'll go Yeti. Ironbark Protector, Golchar Footman, Frost Elemental. Ironbark Protector is really, really good if you can play it early. It does synergize pretty well with Nourish, and also it synergizes very, very well if you have something like Innervate plus the coin. You can get that out there on turn as early as turn 5 or sooner. So I think we'll take a risk here and go for an Ironbark Protector. Normally I would go for the Goldshire Footman or the Frost Elemental, but we're going to take some risk with this deck. It's probably going to be like the most horrible deck of all time, but hey, that is the name of the game. Innervate, Naturalize, and Gurbash Berserker. Naturalize is phenomenal, because it does indeed remove a minion. However, your opponent does gain 2 cards. Now, as we were talking about on the Iron Bar Protector, however, with Innervate, Innervate does do very, very well, especially if you have a super duper strong minion like an Iron Bar Protector, or hell, even you can get a Silverhand Knight out on as early as turn 3, turn 2, if you have the coin. So I think we'll go Innervate here just because it is a no-cost card. Moonfire, Windfury Harpy, or Priests of Alun. I'm not a huge fan of Moonfire. I'm not planning on having any spell power minions in here. I think we go Harpy here. Yeah, we'll go with Harpy. Harpy is a card that I usually don't pick up all that often, but when given these choices, again, I'm not a huge fan of Priestess of Alun. I'd rather have the Wind Fury. The Harpy is tankier than the Priestess of Alun. Yes, you get 4 health, but I'm not worried about it. So we'll go Harpy. Starfire, Fairy Dragon, and Loot Hoarder. Starfire is super good. However, it costs 6 mana, and there's a lot. I can do a lot more with a Druid deck besides just deal 5 damage. Yes, you do get a card draw, but I would much rather have something like the Fairy Dragon or the Loot Hoarder. Fairy Dragon's probably going to be the best choice here just due to the fact that it cannot be targeted by hero powers. They need to use an AoE or board clearing ability, something like that to get rid of it. It's very, very good. It's almost a guarantee. It's almost like a stealth, except better, almost. Almost. Gadget Auctioneer, Mana Wraith, and Mana Addict. Now, this is an interesting concept here because I do favor both of these cards in my Rogue deck. Druids don't really play quite like Rogues. They do in a sense that you can have a lot of low-cost cards but have a lot of spells as well. I think I'm going to go with the Auctioneer here just in case because I have really no true way to protect the Mana Addict, unlike my Rogue deck where I would have Conceal or some way to protect her. I think we'll go Auctioneer here because it's a phenomenal resource to have with all those card draws, all the card draw that you get. Faceless Manipulator, Ancient of War, and Force of Nature. Force of Nature is interesting here. Ancient of War isn't really all that impressive to me. Faceless Manipulator, however, is very impressive. And imagine this. Just picture this really quick, if I may, nerds out there. Imagine having a super duper very fast turn 4 or at worst turn 5 Ironbark Protector. I can throw out the Faceless Manipulator there and all of a sudden my 1-888 becomes a 2-888. And very good indeed. I love Faceless Manipulator. It's a very, very good card. Yes, both of these, especially Force of Nature, are okay, but the Manipulator, you gotta go Faceless on that. One of my favorite cards. Bargain Nature, Starfire, and Fen Creeper. We don't really have any taunts right now, but we have a lot of 5 cost cards. So I think we'll go with another Mark of Nature here. It would be nice to combine this with, like, say, a Yeti or, hell, even the Ironbark Protector or Silverhand Knight would be very, very good. Starfire is still a little bit tempting, but I'm hurting for the early game, and I need something early. So we'll go ahead and get Mark of Nature. South Sea Deckhand, Naturalize, and Grimscale Oracle. Now, what's neat about the South Sea Deckhand is that the charge, while you have a weapon equipped, does indeed work with the... I believe it works with the Druid deck. I'm not going to guarantee that, but I think it does. Not planning on having any oracles here. I think we'll go Naturalize only because we may need the end game. Naturalize is kind of like an end game. You just need to remove a tank or a taunt or something like that. So I think we'll go Naturalize, even though I don't like giving my opponent 2 cards. That's what you got to do. Another Starfire. It's the third Starfire we've seen. Frost Elemental and Bloodsail Raider. I think we'll go finally. We'll begrudgingly take the Starfire. I really want the Frost Elemental, but we have a lot of late game options right now. We'll go Starfire. Spiteful Smith, Naturalize again, or an Argent Squire. I love the Argent Squire. That's such a good card for turn 1. Easy pick for me. Shieldbearer, another Yeti, or an Oasis Snapjaw. I do like these Snapjaws because of the huge health pool that they have. Shieldbearers can be good if you do throw on a Mark of Nature that 0-4 becomes a 4-4 by turn 3. This is a tough one. I think we go Shieldbearer here just to have the early taunt, or if I need a oh crap, we need to get a taunt out now moment, then Shieldbearer would be good. So we'll go Shieldbearer here. Druid of the Claw, easy pick here. Crusader is very, very good, as well as the Darkscale Healer, but I think we go because of the fact that it does have charge, and we can also combine that with a Mark of Nature or something else that buffs it. We'll go Druid of the Claw. Ironforge Grizzly, Ironforge Rifleman, and Bluegill Warrior. I think what we do here is go for as much as I would like to have the Ironforge Rifleman, and I know this is going to sound crazy, but the 2 charge damage that you get from a Bluegill Warrior is very, very potent, especially, again, when you're talking about having the ability to buff a minion. That 2 damage becomes 6 damage very, very quickly, and it can take people off guard. Very good for late game removal, or if you need to slam dunk something at the end. Surprisingly good. Surprisingly good. Another Naturalize, a Loot Hoarder, and another Mark of Nature. I don't know if I can take 3 of them. I really want to get the Loot Hoarder out there just because of the draw card. Yeah, we'll go Loot Hoarder. Going to try to play it a little bit safe. Alarmabot, Cold Light Oracle, and Knife Juggler. I love the Knife Juggler. It's very, very good, especially since the fact that you can buff its health and it will last forever. Oracle is not that bad. Again, I don't like giving another player a card draw, and I'm just not a fan of Alarmabot, but we'll go Knife Juggler here. It's a good card. A fifth Naturalize, Armani Berserker, and Boulder Fist Ogre. I think we go with the Berserker. Man, this deck really wants me to play Naturalize really, really badly. I'm not going to. Another Starfire, Gurbashi Berserker, or Power of the Wild. I think we'll go Power of the Wild here. Again, the aforementioned, we do have charge minions. We have easy ways to buff them to ridiculous proportions. That is the name of the game that Druid plays. We'll go Power of the Wild here. Into Brewmaster, Flesh-Eating Ghoul, and Murloc Raider. I think we go Brewmaster. We have literally, we only have one play on turn four. I love the Brewmaster. The fact that you can save minions if it's getting crowd controlled, or you can use the Battle Cry again. It's super duper good. Dalaran Mage, Wind Fury Harpy, and Silver Moon Guardian. The Mage is an interesting choice here, but I don't have enough spells to really facilitate that. I think we go Silver Moon Guardian here. The Divine Shield is awesome, and again, that's another good minion to buff to almost guarantee that it will either get crowd, you can force the crowd control, or you can buff it and get a guaranteed attack. So I love the Guardian on that one. Acidic Swamp Ooze, Swipe, and Power of the Wild. Gotta go Swipe here. As much as I would love to have an anti-weapon card, I think Swipe is just too good. Swipe is super duper good. Another Silvermoon Guardian, Shattersun Cleric, and Frost Elemental. Shattersun Cleric, bar none, easy pick. One of the best three cost cards in the game, in my opinion. And we've got four cards left to draw. Goldshire Footman, Ogre, and Dread Corsair. I'm not a huge fan of really any of these cards in this setup. I think we'll go with Footman just to have another taunt. Ogres are pretty good, but again, I have some late game. I have plenty of late game options, so we'll go for another Footman, or for a Footman. Claw, Dalaran Mage, or Nightblade. Claw is very, very good. It's nice to have whenever your opponent is not expecting you to deal three damage out of nowhere. I'll take Claw here. Very good. It does synergize very well with the Gadgetzan Auctioneer, so we'll take Claw. Two cards left to go. Another Starfire, Wrath, and Direwolf Alpha. I think we go with a Wrath here. I really don't need two Starfires. I'd like to have, again, the guaranteed card draw. Plus, I get to deal three damage if I need to. Direwolf Alpha, super duper good for most decks. It's good for Druids as well, but I like having Wrath. And again, that does indeed synergize with our Auctioneer if the Auctioneer comes out at a opportune time. Last card is going to be a legendary, Alexstrasza, Haga, or Tankmaster Overspark. Now, the funny choice here is that Tankmaster Overspark is a very, very good card if it works out in your favor. The battle cry is transform a minion into either a 5/5 Devil Sore or a 1/1 Squirrel at random. The best choice here is going to be Hogger. Alexstrasza isn't that bad for Druids based on how many Nourishes you have or how many Innervates you do have, unfortunately, or Wild Growths, I guess. We only got one Innervate, and I think we only got one Nourish out there, so unfortunately Alexstrasza is going to be out. We're going to take Hogger here because it's a 4/4. It does summon a a Null with Taunt at the end of each of my turn, easy for me to say. And I think we'll go Hogger there. He's a good turn 6 option. If we need him early, we do have Innervate, and if we go second, we have the coin, we can get him out there by turn. I guess that'll be turn 3. So let's go with Hogger. And there you go. So if you stuck with us through the draft, we had a lot of fun, a lot of good cards. I'm not sure how I feel about the overall synergy of the deck. I think we have a good chance to do better than most, but every time I say that, we have like the worst arena run ever, and then I just don't upload those because they're really, really bad. If you clicked here through the annotation at the beginning of the video, then welcome out here to the Game 1 pregame show. We do have a lot of really good cards. Ended it on a very, very positive note. We did get Hogger, which is going to help immensely. We do have some early acceleration as far as mana is concerned. A lot of cards draw, which is what I like. Let's see how that translates into the arena as we go into game one. Hopefully Battle.net doesn't crash on me here as it did I think it was the Hunter, the most recent Hunter run that I did, where Battle.net actually was not responding for the first like 10 minutes and I had to cut that video short. So hopefully we'll get a match. It does look like it is loading up. So let us see how game one goes for the Druid deck. It's a new Durin deck, and it looks like we're going up against a Priest here. Priest versus Druid is a very interesting matchup indeed. Looks like we are going to go first. We don't really need Hoggear here. It would be nice to keep the Silverhand Knight out, however, and I think we're going to do just that. Now we'll keep Power of the Wild in case we need to buff something or if we need to get that 3-2. Swipe comes out. Not a very good... It really isn't a good trade-off there. I would have much rather had Hoggear had I known that was going to be there. Turn one, nothing really much that we can do. We're just going to roll it on over. And that is the that's one of the bad, I guess that's one of the downsides to having a lot of really high cost cards is the fact that if you do draw them early, you are in a lot of trouble. Luckily, we do get the Armani Berserker to come out, and that will be a good card to bait out a Smite or possibly even have him throw out a Shadow Ward Pain. If he coins into it, I believe Shadow Ward Pain's. It may be a two-cost card. I'm not quite sure. I don't play Priest all that often, so we'll have to wait and see what this Priest will do. I like the Berserker because it does. Here comes the coin, and it's going to be Acolyte of Pain. That is an interesting play. Okay, so he's looking for early card draw there, and he does deal one damage with the Northshire Cleric. Now we could naturalize here. And I don't think that's not really a bad option. If we naturalize plus play Power of the Wild, if I play Power of the Wild, that will guarantee. Well, I wouldn't have to use naturalize if I use Power of the Wild. So let's go ahead and use that and buff our Armani Berserker to 3/4. We take out the Acolyte of Pain, and that way he does not get only but one card draw to that. There's no reason for us to play anything else right now. There's no reason to naturalize the Northshire Cleric. Armani Berserker's already ticked off and doing 6 damage on turn 3. So that will undoubtedly bait out a Silence or a Shadow or Death, and there it is. So we basically played 2 cards to get him to play 3, including the coin, which is not that bad of a job there. I think what we do is just armor up and go straight for the priest. I'm not going to attack the Northshire Cleric because I do not want to give him an option of healing it and getting a free card for just the cost of 2 mana. And I think we all know what's coming up next. We're going to go straight to Silverhand Knight unless if something juicier comes up. So, turn 4 for the priest. It should be a big, scary taunt minion here. No, it's going to be a light well. Okay. And will he enter fire? He's just going to throw out the mind blast to deal a net total of 4 damage. Now back up to 5. I said 4 damage because we had armor. Goldshire Footman comes out, and that's a good card indeed. However, we don't really need it. We do have the Silverhand Knight, and we will get the 2/2 squire out as well. Light well does its thing. And will there be a Holy Nova here? Holy Nova would not be a bad option. And nope, he's just going to play the Ironfork Grizzly and also throw out a Mind Vision, so he's going to copy one of our cards. Hopefully he didn't get Hoggear, but with my luck, he probably did. It would not surprise me one bit. Uga Warrior comes out, and that is a very, very good card here. I think what we do is we definitely need to swipe. We can swipe and pretty much clear the board, and I think that is a good option. So let's go ahead and swipe, and down goes all of that. And then what we do is we take out the Northshire Cleric and take out the Light Well. We could also go for a Goldshire Footman here, and I think that is probably a good option as well. I didn't want to use Naturalize on the Night Well because I think I'm going to probably need Naturalize later on. So if this priest has a Holy Nova, now is the time for him to use it. And he's going to use a Voodoo Doctor, I'm guessing. A Witch Doctor. Oh, wow. He copied Swipe from the hand. That is really, really lucky for him. So that's bad for us. That is quite unfortunate. Wrath comes out. That'd be a good card for us to save here. I really don't want to throw out the Bluegill Warrior. I think what we do is play Hoggear, deal 1 damage, and then hopefully hold on to Hoggear. Man, the fact that he got Swipe, I had 6 cards in my hand, and that happened to be the one that the RNG gods decided to give to this priest, and that is unlucky for us. Super unlucky for us. So hopefully we'll have to see what kind of ramifications that's going to cause. Now with Hoggear out there, let's see, here comes a light spawn, and he's going to Divine Spirit to make that a 10-10, and that will make a very juicy target for us to naturalize. As much as I really, really do not want to give this priest a card advantage over me, I can't allow him to have a 10-10. So let's go ahead and take out the light spawn here. I could innervate to go to the Iron Bark Protector. I don't think I quite need to do that. Let's go ahead and armor up and deal our damage. Hogger will give us another Knoll here. I'm not going to use the Bluegill Warrior because that's something I'm going to want to slam dunk home. And now that we have firm board control, we technically have a 1 hit point lead thanks to our armor. So, but one Holy Nova can change basically the entire game here. Now, with turn 8, we do have to worry about mind control. So here comes one Shadower Pain. Shadower Pain is a 2-cost card, so that is something that I'll remember from now on. He still has the option to do a Holy Nova if he has it, but that would be almost a waste at this point. But he needs to do something because we are going to drop down the Ironbark Protector as well as have the possibility of using Wrath.
Get behind me.
So, and that is going to be, I think, what our play here is going to be is just that. So let's go ahead and drop out the big, scary Ironbark Protector. We can open up with Wrath as well. Deal 3 damage to the Booty Bay Bodyguard. And we will toss away our Golchar Footman. He did a very good job for us. We'll get another taunt out there just to have an extra layer of protection. And Hogger doing a phenomenal job. Hogger is the MVP of this battle so far. But look at all the taunt out there. Even if the priest does indeed mind control the Ironbark Protector, we still have options enough to take it out. And I wouldn't mind baiting out a mind control here or mass dispel. Here comes the mind control. No, it's going to be another Shadow Word Death. So 2 Shadow Word Deaths in his opening hand is unfortunate for us. And this is the same priest that also Mind Vision Swipe. So, Torn Warrior comes out. It's going to be a Taunt and Rage plus 3 attack. Shattered Sun Cleric, and that is a good card here. I think what we do is we could Shattered Sun. He's got 15 health, so if we Shattered Sun the Shield Bearer and then take it out with a free Knoll, I could armor up and then take out the... I could take out the Scarlet Crusader's shield. Alternatively, I could also go for Broke here, and I think that might be the better option because we have no more cards. And if we just go all in at this point, well, you have to be cautious of Holy Nova, but honestly, if he had Holy Nova, he would have used it by now. So we have to just hope that he does not top deck Holy Nova. So I think what we do here is we can Shattered Sun Cleric the Bluegill Warrior, and that way we don't have to deal any damage to the Shield Bearer, and then just go for the priest there. What? There's no reason for me to throw away any minions to a 3-1. Or alternatively, we can throw away one of the Gnolls. And then I could pop the bubble, but no, I don't think that's a good option. So let's go ahead here and thank you to the Bluegill Warrior. I think I'd much rather do that. And as we say, Hogger, what I could have done, I could have played one of the free Gnolls into the 3-1 to do a complete removal, but I think I'd rather have the extra damage right now. I don't know if that's the smartest play. It probably isn't the smartest play, but hey, I'm not. I never said I was going to the Hearthstone Invitational as a player. So, Thought Steal. So, let's see how lucky this already lucky priest can get. Thought Steal. Hopefully, I don't think we have another. The only other AoE card that we have would be Starfall. And we only have one of those, so hopefully he did not get that. So, he's going to throw away the 3-1 to the 2-2. And if he doesn't play something massive here, the game is over, pretty much over. So he's targeting Hogger, and look at that, he did get Starfire. Unbelievable how lucky this guy is, but I think the game is still over. 1 mana left, and yeah, that's it. So we will take the win here in game number 1 of the Druid Run. Luckily, Lady Luck wasn't too against us, although that priest did get That priest did get quite fortunate with those thought steals and mind vision. So, gonna wrap this one up here. Thank you very much for watching Game 1. Looking forward to releasing the rest of the arena run. Hopefully it goes well. It's been a while since I played a druid in the arena, and we're off to a good start. So, hope you had a great, fantastic day. And, of course, I will see you all next time. So long, everybody.